Hello there, this is Santi. Welcome to the podcast, and today I'm going to jump straight away into a quote that I love that I think is going to be really relevant to today's topic. It just goes like this. How long are you going to wait before you demand the best for yourself? So this is Epictetus, and I think it's a brutal quote about the topic that I want to talk about today. So it's New Year resolutions. Now, I'm talking about this because I believe New Year resolutions expire by the end of January. I think it's quite sad because we say 2020, we're motivated. It's all the motivation we have to achieve better health, better relationship goals or financial goals, professional goals, whatever we have in mind. We say, okay, 2020 is the time to go and achieve these things. But I believe towards the end of January, that motivation starts going away. And today I just want to talk about something because I noticed this in myself. Like I want to make sure that I keep myself accountable and achieve the things that I want to achieve. So what this year I set out to do, it's a zero alcohol for the duration of 2020. So no alcohol for the whole year. I think a lot of people do like the idea of dry January, which means not drinking for the whole of January. If you've been doing that, I highly recommend you go through the whole 2020 thing. Or even if you haven't done that fully, why not commit to this thing? And I'll give you reasons. I'll give you reasons why I believe this is a good goal, a good challenge to set ourselves. I understand it's very hard for some people, especially at different stages in life. But here are some of the reasons why I believe a zero alcohol challenge is really valuable. And some people have already jumped on board on this, which has been really cool. We're keeping each other accountable. I'll talk more about that in case you want to join the little community group that we have going on. But yeah, here are some of the reasons. First is discipline. I believe discipline is one of the most important skills we can develop in life, whether it's about achieving a certain goal, such as this challenge, the ability to say no to things that we know are damaging for us or that will get us away from what we want to achieve. It's essential to develop the discipline to be able to commit to whatever we want to achieve. And yeah, to me, like the zero alcohol for the whole year is going to help me develop healthy relationships. I believe a lot of relationships are based around just, you know, going out for a beer or drinking. I believe some relationships can be very healthy with that being involved, like, you know, like going for a beer, there's nothing wrong with that. But I think a lot of us have those friends. We all have at least one friend who we can only hang out with them when we're drinking or something, because that's what the relationship is like. Like, you need the alcohol in order to sustain the relationship. So I believe by setting out a challenge to not drink for a whole year, you can start filtering out and maybe realizing which friends are uplifting you, are helping you to become a better person, and which ones not. And I believe even though alcohol can be managed in a healthy way, I do believe it's important to recognize which friendships maybe depend too much on alcohol. And maybe you could try to fix that relationship, or you could try to just, you know, not be with those people anymore in case it's someone who's damaging you in a negative way, right? And besides that, I believe not drinking can help us achieve more meaningful work. I think when we have extended periods of time of sobriety, of having this clarity of mind, we have not only more time, but also more energy, and we're in a better state to produce a meaningful work that we care about. And I think some of the reasons why some of us might be hesitant to try something as a whole year without drinking, because it is challenging, is mostly because I believe of social pressure. I believe social pressure is something that gets us really stuck because we are drawn towards doing what other people like us are doing. If we are young and we are maybe, I don't know, it depends on the stage you are in life, but either university, college, or high school, or maybe a bit older, and you have your friends and this is what your friends do, you feel like an outcast. You feel like not part of the group if you're not doing what other people are doing, which is going for that beer or going to a party and getting drunk. Like, if you're not being part of that, you feel pressure towards acting like the people around you. Another thing is, I believe it's escapism, which I believe to a certain extent is not very, it's not necessarily damaging, but I think things like alcohol or social media or watching too much TV, Netflix, or whatever you're addicted to or getting too engaged with can be a form of escapism that can be damaging for you. To a certain extent, I do believe we all need to, you know, let go of all the stresses that are in our head and change the pattern, do something different. But when it becomes too close to becoming the thing we need in order to feel good or in order to relieve stress every time. It's the same thing with smoking or all of these vices. Like, they can be very damaging, and I believe alcohol can be easily, it can easily become into a vice. And I think this is because alcohol is so ingrained in our culture because of convention. And I believe convention has really the power to tell us, no, don't worry, this is what people do. It's normal to do this thing. It's normal to act this way. It's normal to get drunk every week. And we have to fight convention in order to achieve, to become the person we want to be, because we will never be the person we want to be by following convention. I'm a believer in that. I don't think convention offers us as much room for growth as it could. I think the norm is to engage in all these things, such as drinking every week, or, well, depending on the level at which someone manages their alcohol. Like, some people really struggle. I mean, alcoholism is no joke. And yeah, some other people just say, no, it's normal, this is what everyone at my age does. I think there's something dangerous about that. So, not necessarily always. I think it's a matter of you reflecting, like, okay, is my relationship to alcohol damaging right now? Even if you don't want to engage with this whole challenge of a whole year, because I know it's really hard. But even if you don't do that, I do encourage you to reflect on your relationship with alcohol, whether it's something that is damaging you or whether it's something that you can manage and maybe it's not a problem right now. So yeah, this relates to the idea of it's called the Mathew's principle, which states that the bad gets worse and the good gets better. So this principle really goes down into the idea of habits. Habits are the idea that whatever you do repeatedly becomes who you are. Well, we are what we repeatedly do. That is how the phrase goes. And that is the idea. When you do something bad, when you do a bad habit, when you engage too much in a negative behavior, it's a downward spiral towards bad things. But it's the same with good habits. If you learn to say no to the things that are damaging for you, if you learn to engage more in the positive activities that make you a better person, it's an upward spiral. It's the same thing. So, like, whether you engage too much in your bad habits, the effects will be negative, of course. And if you engage more in your positive habits, the effects will be positive. So, yeah, just to close a bit with that, I do believe clarity is something worth achieving in anything we're doing. To me, I believe being sober for an extended amount of time, like a year, like fully sober, I think there's something valuable in there. And I think it's going to allow me to have this clarity that will allow me to do not only better work, but also feel better in a lot of ways. So I think we should all strive for clarity of mind. It doesn't have to be necessarily through not drinking at all, but I do believe there's some value in being sober for an extended period of time. So yeah, just strive for clarity. And whatever you do, is strive for clarity. It's so valuable. So in case you've been encouraged to try this out with me, that'd be really cool. I'd love to have you, keeping each other accountable on this. So just to let you know, we have a bit of a community thing going on right now in Instagram. It's just a few people who decided to do this challenge of zero alcohol for the whole year. So we're keeping each other accountable. We're discussing Stoic philosophy. We're discussing philosophy and the reasons to do things like this, to develop our discipline. So if you want to form part of that, just let me know. Message me either to my contact page or to my email, which I'll leave in the show notes, or just send me a message in Instagram, DM me. And I'll be happy to add you to that little group we have. So yeah, I just want to end again with that beautiful quote by Epictetus. How long are you going to wait before you demand the best for yourself? This quote gets me every time. It's so powerful. And I hope it helps you in anything you want to achieve, whether you want to form part of this challenge or whether you have a challenge of your own that you want to achieve. Highly encourage you to follow through, to not rely fully on that motivation, but to rely on your why. Why are you doing the things that you're doing? Finally, if you want to learn more about some of the ideas behind why am I doing this personally, you can check it out in the show notes of this. So it's in santiyanger.com/43. This is episode 43 of the podcast. So I really hope you enjoy this episode. And yeah, I'll see you in the next one. So thanks again for listening, and memento mori. Bye.